name is Mantas. I am working as an IT architect for company Adform. Adform's headquarters are located in Copenhagen, Denmark. Our operation and development teams are located in Lithuania, Vilnius. We are doing business. We are doing business all across Europe. We are biggest player in the Nordics. Basically, what we do, we serving ads, we serving banners. All you could see those. We providing portal for our clients where they could log in, set up a campaign, and then just run it in the internet. Our servers are located in Copenhagen, Denmark too. We have two data centers, about 300 physical servers now. It's a bit more, it's a bit outdated now. It's near 400 maybe physical servers. And we could handle about 70,000 requests per second. And with monitoring, we were at almost zero like last year, or maybe just more than a year ago. We were nothing near where we have now. We had such tool, Perfmon. It's basically very, very simple tool, just log aggregator, where you could see red and black lines, and you could guess maybe which are more critical. So yeah, I can tell you that there's no difference between red and the black lines. Basically, everything was dependent on the guy who was watching it. Very poor texting or something. We didn't have like notification system, nothing. So it doesn't take a genius to understand that we have problems with this approach. And the trigger to do some changes was continuous deployment project. When we started continuous deployment or continuous delivery, we thought, okay, we need a monitoring tool. Without monitoring tool, we won't manage to do this. So as we are Microsoft, as we are using Microsoft products, most of our servers are Windows servers, we basically turned to Microsoft solution for monitoring. So Microsoft solution for monitoring is System Center Operation Manager. SCOM. So we were playing with it like for 2 months. We were doing lots of things with it, but it was great to do very simple things and to do standard things. When we tried to do something out of the box, something different, something not traditional, we had problems straight away. So we didn't bought SCOM, even though we had money for already dedicated for buying SCOM. But it wasn't solution for us. So we looked at other solutions like Nagios, Cacti, Zenos, Splunk. We were looking at all of those, but nothing fits. Nothing fitted us, except you can guess which one. So we turned to Zabbix, and when we were selling it to our management team, basically we were pointing to these three key points: template screens and user parameters. Templates, we had really great ideas how to use them, how we could have like group of people who could make templates, another group of people could do monitoring. Screens, like that was the main thing we were missing in SCOM. Maybe if the SCOM would have something similar to screens, I don't know how it happened, but it didn't. So screens was really, really powerful thing to us, and user parameters, which made Zabbix to enable Zabbix to monitor almost everything. We were fine to writing scripts. We had people good at that, so we were fine with that. So we chose Zabbix. When we start implementing Zabbix,
There was a question: who need to make template? Because operations teams are operation team is monitoring infrastructure. They are monitoring servers, networking. They know everything about it, but they don't know applications. And applications is in the essence of what we are doing. We get money because our applications does what they do. It's not because our servers running smoothly or we do have 10 gigabit connection to the internet. So we need to monitor applications, and the engineers are the guys who write applications, and they know, or they should know, everything about them. Yeah. So they should tell us how to monitor applications. They should tell us where to look at, how to tell its application performing or not. We turned to developers and said, "Okay, could you help us with that?" We made a plan. Said, "Okay, developers, you write applications. You will make a templates for your applications. You will give them to IT guys, to operation guys. They will check them. Are they correct? And they will put them to the Zabbix." And we thought it's really, really great plan. We will succeed it straight of all. But it wasn't so. We failed. And we failed for multiple reasons. Operation guy said, these developers don't know what they are doing. They don't know what they want to monitor. They're doing lots of changes. We tired to work with them to implement all these templates. Even more, they said, what developers are doing, it's not even monitoring. It's like debugging. It's not natural to go to a monitoring server. Developers said, okay, we are tired from operation guys. We don't want to talk with them already. So because we have so many changes, it was obvious it's not working. So we sat down and thought, okay, what we could do. We said, okay, if there's two different approaches to monitoring, let's split them. Let's split the teams and we'll see what happens. We call this monitoring, which was like, it wasn't like dedicated for IT, but its purpose was to tell if our system running at the moment. And it's metrics system, which purpose was to tell how our applications doing, how to tell about trends and all of that stuff. We made as simple as possible for developers and operations to use those. Just implemented Windows authentication, implemented, just write some instructions how to start and give access to them. Basically, developers could do almost anything on a metric server. They are administrators, so they could delete host, they could create host. That was the idea that we have really smart developers and they won't do bad things. And yeah. Yeah, but it's working, yeah. It worked. It seems we really have really smart developers. They start using it. Straight of all, when we implemented this approach, we had first adopters. We saw that they are doing, they put lots of items, they are monitoring very, very frequently, but it was like because they didn't know what to monitor exactly, that was a bit new to them, and they monitored everything and very frequently. But we were happy. We were happy because we had some adopters, and we thought, okay, developers already start looking after the applications. It's great. Then we had project called real-time bidding, which is we have ad exchanges in one side, which is like big market, has lots of informations about users, about places where we could show banners. They send us information. They send information to us. We add our information on top of their information, decide if we want to show a banner, and make a bid for with the price. For let's say Jonas once came to the site and we know that Jonas wants to buy a car. We have customer who sells the cars. We say, okay, we will give $1 for if we can show the banner in the correct place. So all the thing was that the round trip from the ag exchange to us and back, it should be more than 100 milliseconds for one request. Like Google Side Exchange is located in Amsterdam and our servers in Copenhagen, and all this process should take less than 100 milliseconds. And we needed to support 40,000 queries per second to do this. And we put our policies in place. We bought hardware, we write application, we did other things, we put monitoring on top, and we said, okay, it should go. And it was disaster. It was disaster that we could only handle only 5,000 copias, and 25% of them failed because they couldn't manage to make in less than 100 milliseconds. So we turned to the developers and said, okay, you are monitoring your application, so let's tell where is the bottleneck? Why are you performing so bad? What's wrong? They said, okay, yeah, we are monitoring our system, but we can't tell you. We don't know, actually. So it was for us like it was a bit embarrassing. We are collecting lots of data. It seems we are looking after our applications, but we can't say where the bottleneck is. What we did? We took the data, which was already collected. We organized the data, correlated the data, additional counters when we did the first two. Then we picked really important metrics and pushed on those. So how we organize the data? We split data in such a way that we created separate dashboards for infrastructure, separate dashboards for application latencies and business metrics. In such a way we could search for the problem or bottleneck and we could see what we are already covering and where we are missing for data. We correlate data in such a way that we put quite a few of graphics, one below each other. And we could straightly see that if we are doing like stress testing in here, we could see how our database, which was Cassandra NoSQL database, how it reacts, and down to TCP queues. And from the bottom to the top, we could see that if we have some problems with our storage, we could see how it affects our latencies, how it affects our SLA. And we correlate data in different way. We correlated data, like time shifted data, which is on this graphic, it's the same data, which is bits we are sending per second. But we put like how many bits we are sending now, how average of last hour, how many bits we are sending 24 hours ago, still average of 1 hour, and how many bits we sending 1 week ago, average of 1 hour. In such way, we could straightly see if something goes wrong, like we are sending too much bits now, or we are sending too little bits, we could straightly see that there's real problem in our system, maybe even in configuration somewhere. Actually, now having this kind of graphs, we actually can say when user does some misconfiguration in its part, and we actually saving money for users just watching those graphs and says, okay, just someone called this client and tell him that he's spending too much money, and he so we are actually saving money for users. For our clients. Added additional counters. This example how we added external counters. We knew that Ad Exchange is in Amsterdam, Google's Ad Exchange is in Amsterdam, and we already knew the data which Google sent to us, how we look like from Amsterdam, but it was like from Google perspective. So we didn't if we wanted different perspective, not only from Google, so we implemented application in the Windows Azure. which was called from the Zabbix. It was a simple item, which was calling application located in the Windows Azure Cloud. Application itself made the post request to our system, back to our system, collects the latencies, collects other data, and reports it to Zabbix. We are putting graphs on it, and we can see other perspective other than our partner, like Google at this time, giving to us. But we added lots of additional counters to our application itself. We are starting monitoring down to TCP queues, threads application run, how many threads application makes, and all such things. Then we put like the goal with the team which was dealing with that issue. We put the goals on them, just like you have 2 weeks to just make like just make us to handle like 20,000 queries per second, and that fails wouldn't go above like 2%. So we pushed on that, and in a couple of months I think we were going like we were removing bottleneck after bottleneck. There wasn't like one high smoking chimney with like CPU utilization. It was lots of small bottlenecks which were stopping us. So in a couple of months we are removing these bottlenecks, and at the end we reached like now we could handle like more than 70,000 queries per second to that particular system part only, and the percent of fails it's less than 0.5%. And we did that in the on the same hardware we had initially had. So it was like, wow, it was like great achievement for us. Everybody was happy. And it was done by developers. There was no operation team involved in this. Developers were creating the counters in the application, creating applications in Windows Azure Cloud. They were doing all that stuff themselves, finding bottlenecks all themselves. Yeah, and what we have now, as I said, we have two Zabbix servers now, still. That 400 values per second we are collecting, I must say it isn't changing a lot. Like, we are watching a lot more things now than we used to be, but we are dropping other things, so that number keeps the same. We have still growing number of triggers. What we monitor, yeah, of course applications, of course servers and network equipment, still that is important, and it's monitored. We are monitoring latencies both internally and externally. We are monitoring latencies between our applications, between our servers, even in the same application between different parts. We are monitoring Amazon Cloud solution, how much money we spend. We monitor how many instances we have running and how many we have stopped. We are monitoring even some jobs on Amazon Cloud. And actually we are monitoring money minute by minute case. In some projects we could do that we could monitor those. Of course we don't do the billing on the data, but we are monitoring those, and developers could see that, and they see if they do some wrong thing, the misconfiguration or some misrelease or something like that, they could actually could see how much money they lost. That application, how much money we lost during that time, so, or how more money we are getting if they do something really great. So it's actually helping in that way. Actually, we're correlating how much money we earn and how much bits we have. These two data shouldn't split. We are working using Agile practices, Scrum in particular. And now our teams, not all I must say, but our teams are looking after their applications. Project manager sets goals, looking at the metrics, looking at the different parameters, and they set goal on that. If it needs to be like night watched or like it should be put under surveillance, some items or other things. So we still, operation team gets involved in that. I put some quotation from our developers. As I said, it's like 1 year we trying to work with metrics, and it's clearly we can see clearly how it affects all of us. When we had like migration from 1A to 0, we had a downtime, and one developer came to me and said, "Okay, now I'm not feeling comfortable. You know, I'm like blind. I can't see nothing." It is strange because like a couple of months ago I didn't know anything and I was like okay and feeling great, and now if I'm not looking in the graphs while I'm working, I'm feeling really bad. It's not okay. Other teams are joining us. As I said, not all teams progressed equally. So we have still some teams to catching up. And the last guy, he sent me on the Skype. He left the date and the time for purpose. That he said, "Look what I have. What I have done. And it's the date is like Sunday almost midnight, and we don't force like our developers to work at night at Sunday nights, but they have the tools. They see opportunity to do something great." They spend the time, or they see opportunity to make they work easier or life easier, oh yeah, or maybe it's the same. So they really really don't count the time. What they have done, what we are missing in Zabbix, it's like graphing tools, and we need lots of very different graphs. What we have done here, it's like we put Google Graphs on top, like developers did. Like they put Google Graphs on top to see data in the way they wanted to see. It's all up database sizes, I think, and then this one. Someone needed to see visualize our backup system. So they didn't trust triggers and emails. So say let's visualize those. So they did that. Other things we are doing: we are monitoring our team's performance. We actually look how they perform during the month, how much releases and at what quality releases. We are looking at transactions. This is made by HiCharts on top of Zabbix data. We are extracting Zabbix data through API and putting HiCharts graphing on top of it. Yeah, we need to monitor latency, so we put we made such kind of map where we could clearly see in which countries we have problems and where we are doing good. So, and this screen, yeah, it's like someone told that he needs like in Agios, he needs like status green, yellow, and red. It's only started. We just did that. It's like for that purpose, for replacing Agios. To make it work, we split it in different objects, and we the three states: green, yellow, and red. We are doing this getting information from IT services from Zabbix. We play this like we are creating things in IT services and then extracting it through PHP through API. And creating such things, but yeah, I don't know how it will evolve. As I said, it's pretty new, but yeah, we are doing something like now. Yeah. So why it worked? Why developers now look after metrics? Why they do monitoring themselves? We show them true value. How how to solve real life problems using monitoring, using the data we are collecting from servers. We pick really right tools. I think Zabbix was really, really great tool for that. There were no men in the middle like operations team. Developers themselves could do, they can configure templates really in production without no man in the middle. And in some teams, we have management support really helps. If some developers doesn't understand those, so management does and they pushes them a bit. So that's help. Okay, thank you for listening.